इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज बेंजनपदी मंगलूर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग अक्रेडिटेड टू एमबीए. सो इन दिस सेशन डीसीईटी 2020 द पार्ट 1 एंड 2 मॉड्यूल नंबर 1. सो इट विल कवर्स इन दिस मॉड्यूल नंबर 1 लेथ एंड थ्योरी ऑफ मेटल कटिंग. सो माय नेम इज रमेश एस देसाई एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग कैनरा इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज बंटवाड़ा बेंजनपदी बंटवाड़ा. So in this session, so I will discuss about the MCQ multiple choice questions on a drilling machine. So question number one, which of the following operations we cannot perform on the drilling machine? Option given: A, reaming; B, tapping; C, lapping; and D, none of the above. The right answer is a lapping. Lapping is not a process. It is a rubbing process. Lapping is a machining process, is a in which two surfaces are rubbed together with abrasive between them by hand movement or machine using the machine. Question number two, tapping attachment is included in the dash method of tool holding device. Option is given A, by chuck, by sleeve, by directly fitted in the spindle. None of the mentioned. So the right answer is D, none of the mentioned. So it is included in a special attachment method. In tapping, one end is always thinner than the other end. Question number three, floating holder is included in a dash method of tool holding device. Option is given, so by directly fitting in the spindle, by special attachment, by socket, none of the above. The right answer is by special attachment. So in this special attachment, floating holder is a type of a holder that permits the certain amount of freedom to enable to tool with the purpose of maintaining a proper path relative to the work. Question number four, which of the following method is not used for the holding the tool? Option is given A, by a sleeve, by chuck, by socket, and none of the mentioned above. The right answer is none of the mentioned. So these are all methods are used for holding tools. The various types of chucks used in the lathe machines, 2-jaw chuck, 3-jaw chuck, and 4-jaw chuck, etc. Sleeve and socket are also used in this purpose. Question number 5, which of the following devices is not used for holding the work in a drilling machine? Option is given steel block, drill jigs, both step block and drill jigs, and D is none of the mentioned. The right answer is D. So both are used for the holding the work in a drilling machine. So next, question number 6, the drilling machine was preliminarily designed to originate a flat surface, cylindrical surface, taper surface, none of the mentioned. The right answer is D. So it was preliminarily designed to originate a hole, but now it can perform variety of operations. Question number 7, part of a twist drill which carries the flute and extends from the dead center up to the start of the neck is known as. Option given body, next option point. So option C, leaf. Option D, chisel edge. So the right answer is a body. Body of a drill bit, it is a twist drill, carries a flutes and extends from dead center up to the start of the neck. This is a longest part of the twist drill or drill bit. So next, question number 8, part of drilling between neck and tang is known as. Option given body, point, sank, chisel edge. The right answer is a sank of the two. Sank of a twist drill is between neck and tang. That's why the answer is part of the drill between the neck and tang is known as a sank. Question, you can see that figure clearly understand the tool nomenclature of drill bit or drilling tool. So all parts are given in the figure. So next question number 9, edge formed at extreme tip due to the intersection of the planks is known as. Option is given in this question, body, point, leaf, chisel edge. The right answer is chisel edge. The edge formed at extreme tip due to the intersection of the plank, chisel, is known as a chisel edge. Chisel edge is formed at the extreme tip due to the intersection of plank. It is at the extreme edge of a chisel edge. Question number 10. Cone shaped surface formed at the end of the flute which contains dead center tip. Dead center, tips and planks, etc. is known as. Option given, body, point, leaf, chisel edge. So the point is a cone shaped surface. The point at the end of the drill bit, the cone shaped surface formed at the end of the flute which is contains dead center, lips and plank, etc. is known as a point. The right answer is B. Next question number 11. Main cutting part of the drill is. Main cutting part of the drill is body, point, tip, chisel edge. The right answer is the main cutting part of the drill bit or drill tool with the help of lip. The right answer is the main cutting part of the drill is, it is called as a lip. So lip is the main cutting part of the drilling and is also called as a cutting edge. So material removed first at a chisel edge. Question number 12. Small clearance provided in diameter of the twist drills adjustment to land is known as. Option is given, body clearance, point clearance, lip clearance, chisel edge clearance. The right answer is a body clearance is a right answer. So body clearance is provided in a diameter of the twist drill adjacent to land. This clearance help in the removal of the material during the cutting in the form of chip coming though during the time of metal cutting to remove the material during the cutting process. Question number 13. Which of the following help in reducing the friction between the drill and the walls of the hole in a twist drill? Option is given, body clearance, point clearance, lip clearance, chisel head clearance. The main answer, so the correct answer is body clearance. So body clearance reduces the friction between the drill and the walls. It helps the smooth drilling of the holes during the drilling operations. So next is question number 14. Narrow flat surface running along the flutes of the twist drill on its leading edge is known as. Option, body, point, lip and land. There are four options given. So the land is a right answer. Land is a narrow flat surface running along flutes of a twist drill on its leading. It is the flat part of the twist drill. So next, 15th question. Narrow flat surface running along the flutes of the twist drill on its leading edge is known as body, point, lip, margin. So the right answer is margin. So margin is the narrow flat surface running along the flutes of a twist drill on its leading. It is also known as a land. Question number 16. The question number 16. Next, we can go for the question number 16. Radial drilling machine is column drill machine. Option is given, less than, same as, more than, none of the mentioned above. The right answer is more than. Rigidness rigidness of the radial drill machine is column drill machine. The rigidness is more than the right answer. So radial drills can make a large diameter of holes. So its rigidness should be more column drill machine. Question number 17. Which of the moment is possible in case of the radial arm? So only swell, only up and down, all up and down and swell, none of the mentioned above. The right answer is C, because the radial drilling machine and the radial arm rotates at 360 degree angle and moving also radial arm moving also up and down. So next is question number 18. Which of the following is not true for radial drilling machine? So it can works with jaw with our odd shape. The tabular column is very thick and small diameter. Drill is mounted on the drill spindle, none of the above. The right answer is B. The tubular column is very thick and has a small diameter. So this is the right answer. The tubular is a thick, but it has large diameter, not a small. Question number 19. Which of the following is true of a radial drilling machine? So the option is given. Drilling spindle is subjected to rotation. The entire drilling head is mounted on the radial arm. The gap between the drill and jaw is known as stroke length. And the last option is all of the above. The right answer is B. The entire drilling head is mounted on the radial arm. Which of the following true and radial drilling machine? The entire drill head is mounted on the radial arm in the radial drilling machine. The red tubular is a thick, but it has a large diameter, not small. Question number 20. In which type of radial drilling machine or holding the drill head may be rotated on a horizontal axis? Option is given. Plane drilling machine, so universal drilling machine, semi-universal drilling machine, and universal drilling machine. So the answer is B, universal drilling machine. That is the right answer. So right answer for above question. Arm may be swing around any position over the work bed. Universally machines in addition to the above four moments, arm holding and drill head may be rotated on a horizontal axis. Next you can go for the MCQ on milling machines. Multiple choice questions on milling machines. So the question number 1, the cutting tool in a milling machine is mounted on, option is spindle, arbor, column and knee. The right answer is arbor. So arbor is a rotating element. The one end of the arbor is connected to the vertical column and other end will be connected with the help of yoke. So milling cutter is mounted on the arbor. So next is the process of removing metal by the cutter, which is rotated against the direction of travel of workpiece, is called. So up milling, down milling, so pace milling and end milling. These are the milling process. So the right answer for this question number 2 for up milling and down milling. So up milling means typically the process of the cutting with an end milling utilize both the end of the cutter as well as the sides, which allows the fork cutting and ramp cutting procedure. So you can see up milling and down milling difference is very important. Question number 3. In up milling, the thickness of the chip is minimum at the beginning of the cut and maximum at the end of the cut. Option A. Option B is the maximum at the beginning of the cut and minimum at the end of the cut. Option C, uniform throughout the cut. Option D, none of these. The right answer is the maximum at the beginning of the cut and the minimum at the end of the cut. The B answer is correct. So in up milling, or another name it is called as a conventional milling, the feed direction of the cutting tool is opposite to its rotation. The chip thickness starts at zero and increases towards the end of the cut. That's why the answer B is a right answer, the above question. Next, question number 4. In conventional milling, the cutting force tends to lift the work. So, lift the work, lift the tool, push the table, or none of the above. The right answer is lift the work. Question number 5. In plane milling machine, the table can be moved longitudinally. Option B is crosswise. Option C vertically. Option D all of these. So the right answer is all of the plane milling machine, the table can be moved longitudinally or crosswise or vertically. That's why the right answer is all of these. The operation of the machining several surfaces of the workpiece simultaneously is called profile milling, gang milling, saw milling, helical milling. So that the correct answer is B. That is called as the operation of the machining several surfaces of the workpiece simultaneously can do the work with the help of gang milling. So that is a gang milling is the term of applied to the operation to which the two or more milling cutter are mounted on the same arbor and used when cutting the horizontal surfaces. All cutters may perform the same type of operations, or each cutter may perform different type of operations. So next you can go for the question number 7. The cutting force is directed and this tends to lift the work from the picture of milling. Option is given A, upward, B, downward, can't say anything, none of the mentioned. The right answer is the cutting force is directed upward and this tends to lift the work from the picture of the milling. The right answer is A. The cutting edge, next question number 8. The cutting edge are spaced dash on the circumference of the cutter. So first option is given equal, B option unequal, C option can't say anything, and D none of the mentioned. The right answer is A. The cutting edge are spaced equally on the circumference of the cutter. So has to provide identical surface. If they are not spaced equally, then we can get a smooth surface finish. Question number 9. Milling cutters are made of the made up of material. The milling high speed steel also you can use cemented tip and super high speed steel and all of the mentioned. The right answer is you can use all of these. High speed also you can use that milling cutter. And cemented tip also you can use. So for any one type of material you can use. That's why the right answer is D, super high speed steel. So the milling cutter is made up of a high speed steel or cemented or super high speed steel. That's why the right answer is D. The index is the operation of the dividing the periphery of a piece of the work into, first one is any number of equal parts, 5 equal parts, 16 equal parts, do not divide equally. So the right answer is A, any number of equal parts. So in this definition of indexing, it is generally used for milling machine, but it is also some application in boring, grinding and drill press, etc. So question number 11, indexing is accomplished by using the special attachment known as dividing head, index head, both divide head and index head, and none of the mentioned. So the right answer is C, both divide and index head is required. Index head is also known as a dividing head, and this deriving head is also known as a index head. Question number 12, which of the following is not the type of dividing heads? Question number A, option A, plane dividing head. Option B, universal dividing head, option C optical dividing head, option D all of the main set. So all plane dividing head, universal dividing head and optical dividing head are type of dividing heads. That's why the all of these, all of the main set above, plane dividing head, which of the following is not type of dividing head? Plane dividing head, universal dividing head or optical dividing head. That's why the answer is D. Question number 13. Which of the following is the most common type of indexing arrangement used in the workshops? So now it is almost all generally used in the workshop. A option is given. A plane dividing head, universal dividing head, optical dividing head, all of them mentioned above. The answer is B. Universal dividing head most generally used in the workshops. As per the application of the universal drilling head, it is very, very, very versatile and can be performed various operations. That's why it is used in industries. Question number 14. In universal drilling head, the number of teeth worm wheel has is, option is 36, 18, 40, and none of the no specific number. So the answer is right answer is C. That is a universal indexing head. The number of the teeth worm wheel is 40. Is it a standard? So as per the construction of the worm wheel has 40 teeth for the better function. Taper hole spindle passes through it. In the MCQ on multiple choice questions on rolling machine, rolling mill. Question number 1. Which of the following is not a type of rolling mill? So different types of rolling mills used. So two high rolling mill, clustral rolling mill, separation rolling mill and tandem rolling mill. So two high rolling mill is correct, is there. Cluster rolling mill is also there. Tandem rolling mill is also one type of rolling process. The right answer is which of the following is not type of rolling mills? The answer is C. Answer is which of the following is not a type of rolling type? Separation rolling mill. It is not a separation rolling mill. It is not a rolling process. Only two mill, cluster mill, tandem mill is a rolling process. So explanation is given in this. Separation rolling mill is not a type of rolling mill. In two high rolling mill, what is the direction of the rolling of the two rollers? In two high rollers, suppose example you can take a two rolling mill. What is the direction of the roller rollers? A clockwise and anticlockwise, clockwise and anticlockwise, clockwise and clockwise. Both wheels will be rotated in a clockwise. So anticlockwise and anticlockwise, and stationary and clockwise. The right answer is A, clockwise and anticlockwise. In a two high rolling mill, the direction of the both the rollers is opposite in one another. Hence that one clockwise while the other one is a anticlockwise is the right answer. So next question number 3. In three high rolling mill, what is the direction of the rolling of the three rollers? It is important. Clockwise and clockwise, 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 anticlockwise, anticlockwise, clockwise, anticlockwise, clockwise, anticlockwise, anticlockwise, anticlockwise. The right answer is C. Clockwise, anticlockwise, again it will come the clockwise. Answer is C. Three high rolling mill, the direction of the rollers in the top and bottom are the same and the direction of the roller in the middle is opposite to the two. Next question number 4. Which of the following property does not improve in the hot rolling process of the cast? Ductility, option is given A. Option B is given shock resistance. Option C is a toughness. Option D is a boiling point. So right answer is B, boiling point. Which of the following property does not improve the hot rolling process? So it is a boiling point. When the rolled stack is made, there is an improvement seen in the physical properties of the material. It does not affect the boiling point of the material. Question number 5. Which of the following article cannot be made from rolling? So, rails, helmets, bars, and plate. The right answer is B. So, rolling is very useful of making the article like bars, plates, and rails, but cannot be used in making the helmets. For making a helmets in different method of casting are used. Question number 6. Before beginning the rolling process, the ingots are heated up to what temperature? Below recrystallization temperature of the metal, above recrystallization temperature of the metal, and at recrystallization temperature of the metal, and 1600 centigrade. The answer B is the right answer. Above recrystallization temperature of the metal. Hot rolling is carried out at the temperature above the recrystallization temperature of the metal. Then recrystallization temperature is that temperature at which the crystal lattice structure of the material becomes re-orinated. Which of the following parts? Question number 7. Which of the following parts is used to holding the metal sheet during the planking operation? Option given: A. Spherical steel ball, roller, pressure pad, and magnet. The right answer is C. So the pressure pad is a right answer. So pressure pad or hold down the ring with V-shaped projection is used to holding the metal sheet tightly during the planking operation. Question number 8. Which of the following represents the approximate percentage of metal loss during the blanking operation? Option given: A. 2%, 5%, 10%, and 30%. Which of the following represents the approximate percentage of the metal loss during the blanking operation? Is a maximum 30% is a maximum. The answer is D. The blanking operation of the material loss is approximately 30% of the metal sheet used cutting off operation. To reduce the waste of the material loss, save to arrange the metal sheet properly. Next, question number 9. Which of the following dies is not the type of the cutting dies in the metal cutting operation? Option given: squeezing dies, blanking dies, piercing dies, and notching dies. The right answer is squeezing dies. So blanking dies and piercing dies and notching dies are widely used in the metal cutting operation. But squeezing die is a type of forming die which is used for forming the metal forming operation. In the metal forming, drawing dies and bending dies are also used for forming the metal sheet. Question number 10. Punching a number of holes in a sheet is known as punching a number of holes in the sheet is known as parting, pre-porting, porting, and notching, and lancing. The right answer is perforating. The explanation: punching a number of holes in the sheet is known as perforating. Removing the piece of form of edge of the shaving operation is known as notching. Parting involves the cutting of the shaving of sheet metal in the strip by which the two cutting edges that match opposite sides of the blank. Notching means it is a shaving process during which the metal scrap pieces is removed from the outside edge of the metal workpiece. Question number 11. All the thickness of the sheet is increased, the clearance needs will also increase. Option A. Option B is a decrease. Option C is a no effect. Option D is the first decreases and then increase. The right answer is a thickness of the seat increases, the clearance will also increase. Or so, option is A. As the thickness of the seat is increased, the clearance need will also increase. Clearance need is directly proportional to the thickness of the seat. Question number 12. The process of decreasing the cross section of the bar, increasing its length, is called drawing down, upsetting, spinning, pinning. The answer is drawing down. A. Drawing down. The reversal of the drawing. The process of increasing the cross sectional area of the bar at the expanse its length is known as upsetting. Upsetting involves squeezing fillet between the two plates surfaces, thus reducing the height due to the increase in the cross sectional area. Question number 13. In powder metallurgy, range of particle size in microns is option A is 4 to 200, option B is 0.300 to 0.003, and 100 to 2000, and option D is 5000 to 6000. The right answer is A. In powder metallurgy, range of the particle size is 4 to 200 in microns. 4 to 200 in microns in powder metallurgy. Range of particle size in the powder metallurgy used vary from 4 microns to 200 microns. Powder metallurgy is a small wastage of material. Question number 14. Powder metallurgy is used to produce high precision component with complex cavities and sharp features. Components of a large size. Poracity free components. Components of such alloys whose constituents do not for alloy readily. The right answer is poracity free components. Powder metallurgy process does not make a metal powder by option is given atomization, grinding or milling, hammering, electrolytic deposition. The right answer is hammering. Powder metallurgy process does not make a metal powder by. The right answer is C. It is called as hammering. So the first step is in the overall powder metallurgy process is making a metal powders. These are the four main process used in the powder production: solid state, reduction, atomization, electrolysis and chemical. So thank you. So this is completing the this conclude my lecture.